on to some other airport, Sri Lankan airport, वहाँ पे उसका time second flight morning में होगा, that is not our concern. He was in India up to, so you must count up to 19th February. But in the absence of information, nothing is mentioned. Date of arrival and date of departure, both shall be included in number of days stayed in India. एक note है, clear है? Okay, can I go ahead? So this is one note that our ICI follows. Stay need not to be continuous in nature. Then some people say SSC should come to Mumbai every year. Then only we will count. Why? He can go to Goa. He can go to Delhi. He can go to Jaipur, Jodhpur. Jidhar usko jana, he can travel anywhere in India. Hello? Sometime he can be there just in Indian waters. TWI hai na? Territorial water. In Goa we are having certain casinos and restaurants which are on boat. And those boats are there in ocean. So 4 days he was there on some casino, say for example. Is he in India?
Yes.
Yes, because that whole boat is in India. That vessel is standing in India, you understand? And therefore he was in India. So stay, sir, he stay kidhar hona chahiye? Anywhere in India, yaar. It can be anywhere in India. Stay can be anywhere in India, including TWI. What is TWI? Territorial Water of India. Okay? Some student who has not attended first lecture, so they will not understand what is TWI. There is an India chart. Okay? Next, sir, I came to India for marriage. Sir, I came to India to see my parents. Sir, I came to India because my grandma's sister died. Hello? I came to India to write exam. I just came to India for no reason. Your purpose of visiting India is irrelevant. You came in India, that's important. Stay is important. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? This is the again thing, okay? Before going into exception, let me finish if there is one other note. A residential status has nothing to do with citizenship. You might be citizen of India or you can be citizen of any foreign nation. Even foreign nationals can become a resident here if they stay for more than 182 days. Hello? Chris Gayle is not Indian citizen. If he stay in India for more than 182 days, he will become a resident. You are Indian citizen, tera Aadhaar India ka hai, tera Pan India ka hai, tera Ration card yahan ka hai. But you stayed outside India for 300 days in a current year. Or let's take 320 days in a current year. That means you stayed in India only for 45 days. What is your status? Non-resident. But sir, you are Indian citizen. Toh kya hua? Citizenship has nothing to do with residential status because there are Indians who are non-resident. We call them NRI. Non-resident Indians, bank वगैरह में था ना NRI counter, non-resident Indians. So they are Indian but they are non-resident and there are NRFCs, non-resident foreign citizens, and then there are foreign citizens who are Indian resident. Hello, okay. Sometime in exam has come somewhere, I don't remember even whether BCom exam or CA exam. Husband is resident. And now wife newly got married to that husband. What is her residential status? That we need to check. As per her number of days stay in India, husband resident, that doesn't make wife resident. We have to check a residential status for every person differently. Hello? Because every SSC is a separate entity for us. Okay? Wo bhi ho gaya. Chalo, aage chalte hain. Then, this we will do later.
Foreign also they follow the same.
Every nation has their own rules. Okay. Now that 60 days condition is a horrible condition. Okay. Let me put you into one situation and then you will feel how horrible it is. You are Indian as of now. Assuming you are writing exam in June. Okay. And the moment you are done with your exam, that is around 30th June, okay, you left India. Yes? You were determined that this attempt, this is CMA final and you wrote with a high confidence that you will pass. Sometime you may become ranker also. Alright? And you started looking job abroad. Hello? And to look job abroad, you had cousin or you had friends. So you went to Canada, you started staying there, you started applying for positions and all. So you started staying there. In fact, you got job from July also. Alright, July onwards, somewhere in July, you got a job and you started earning. You tell me, should you pay tax on July to March salary that you earn in Canada in India? Should you pay tax on that? July se leke March tak jo salary kamai Canada mein, wo India mein taxable honi chahiye kya? Hello? Will you be happy to pay tax here? Apne atma ko puchho na, yes sir, happily we will pay tax in India. 30% to India or Canada, they will charge another 20-30%. I'm okay, sir. If 10 lakh rupees is my payment, I will pay 3 lakh rupees tax there and 3 lakh rupees in India. I have a lot of money with me. Is it an attitude? No, obviously it will hurt. What will hurt, you know? Sir, I'm earning in Canada. How Indian government is taking taxes? No? Canadian government taking taxes, that's okay because I'm working in Canada now. But how come Indian government is also taking taxes, sir? Because you became resident. I said you left India on 30th June. That means you were in India for 90 days approximately, 91 days. Hello? April 30, May 31, June 30, 91 days. As per condition 1, you are non-resident. Because condition 1 is not satisfied. Because condition 1 require how many days? 182 days. But condition 2? 60 days. Are you there for more than 60 days?
Yes.
Yes. And more than 365 days or more in previous 4 years, whereas in last 4 years you were there in India only. So your days will cross even 1400. Yes. Hello? Yes. That means you are a resident. 730 days out of 7 years. Will you satisfy this condition also?
Yes,
yes, immediately, sir. I satisfied 2 years only. Why to go for 7 years? Alright. And you should be resident for minimum 2 years. Out of 10 past years, hello, whereas you were resident for 10 out of 10. So what is your residential status, beta? OR. And OR has to pay tax on global income. This is a problem that you must understand with OR. And therefore, we are determining residential status. If you don't know that law, scope of total income, then it will be very difficult to link why this is important. I can teach you chapter independently also. SR residence status. And then you will ask me, no? So why are you teaching us this? Why are you putting this much energy into it? Because if you change residence status, your tax obligation will change. Hello? And if you fill yourself into that situation, then that will hurt somewhere. Nahi yaar, ye galat ho raha hai kahin pe to. Alright. Then you will write letter to Government of India. I already left India on 30th June. Alright, I did not even stay in India for more than 182 days. Why the hell you have incorporated 60 days condition? I did not travel abroad to evade taxes. Did you travel abroad to evade taxes? Like other businessmen, they were counting their number of days and they were traveling abroad. Did you travel abroad to evade taxes or genuinely you left India? Genuinely you left India, yes or no? And therefore then government realized their mistake. Because of our law, harsh law, lot of Indians are suffering taxes in foreign countries also, which is somewhere unethical, not good. Indian image were, Indian government image were spoiled for some days, and then they amended law by putting 3 exceptions to this basic condition number 2. I'm teaching you exceptions. Do you understand the word exception? Exception means where law will not become applicable. Law is that 60 days condition is there, but then exception means that 60 days shall be replaced by 182 days. So in second condition, there is a 60 days condition. That criteria shall be replaced by 182 days only in 3 circumstances. And out of those 3 circumstances, first benefit given to Indian citizen. Indian citizen who leaves India. Indian citizen who leaves India. For what purpose, sir? For employment. Okay, from here for employment. For employment. Employment in India mein hai ki outside India hai?
India.
You left India, that means your employment is outside India, for employment outside India. Am I clear? Alright. Sir, I am going to CMA ki practice wahan pe karne jaane wala. That also includes here. Okay. So, for employment outside India. If you are working as a merchant navy officer, you understand navy officer? People are working on ships and vessels. Alright. And if your vessel about to go to Singapore, where will you go? Singapore. Your vessel want to go to Dubai. Where will you go?
Dubai.
Are you leaving India at your own choice or you are leaving India just because vessel is, wherever vessel go, you have to go along with the vessel? Yes or no? So are you literally counting those number of days, 182? Are khatam ho gaya, chalo boat nikalo. Are you counting? Do you have control over this? No, you have to travel just along with the vessel. Alright, and therefore you are the second person. If you are a crew member of Indian ship, if you are a crew member of
Indian ship,
then also you are covered by second category, where 60 days criteria is not applicable. These two people can become resident in India only if they stay for more than 182 days. If they stay in India for less than 182 days, these two people are non-resident, because they are genuinely leaving India not for tax evasion, for their job. Hello. All right. Now foreigners, foreign citizen, okay, but person of Indian origin. You know Sunny Leone auntie? Respect. I respect for some different reason. Okay, you I don't know. Alright. I respect her because she is a foreigner. She came back to India and she is Indian origin. And she is earning very good amount of money in India and she is paying great amount of taxes. Hello? Not only on Indian income but also on foreign income, because now she is a resident, an ordinary resident in India, and she is having lot of source of income. Alright, she earns hell lot of foreign currency and she is paying that tax with a proud. Hello?
Yes.
Alright, therefore I respect. Sir, but then this benefit is given to all foreign actors and foreign entertainers and all? No. This benefit is not given to them. Is this benefit available to Chris Gayle? No. Alright, Ricky Ponting? No. Because they are simple foreigners. Hello? This benefit is given only for those foreign citizens who are having Indian blood. They are person of Indian origin, PIO, we call them PIO. They are foreigners, but they are having person, they are person of? Sir, how to become person of Indian origin? So either you, assessee, or either of your parent, from mother side or father side, okay? Either of your parent, or either of your grandparent, were born in undivided India. क्या बोला मैंने? नहीं उसके पहले भी बोला. Either assessee or parent or grandparents were born in undivided India, then you will become person of Indian origin. So if your dadaji, now you are in Canada, your dadaji were born in 1945 Karachi, are you a Indian origin? Yes, because in 1945 Karachi was in India. There was a Hindustan. Partition happens in 1946-47 us financial year mein. Alright, abhi 1945 came in exam. You are writing, again I am reminding you are going to write professional exam. Kosa CMA wala or CA, CMA, this kind of exam. You cannot underestimate level of questions. Okay, so whenever you give answer, you must have some kind of general knowledge, and then knowledge, and then you should apply your general knowledge which doesn't exist on knowledge which exists in law, and then you must answer. Okay, so exam hum CMA ka de rahe. Okay, so again I'm asking, Dadaji were in 1945 Karachi, Indian origin or Pakistan origin? Because that time Pakistan did not existed. Hello. Alright, am I clear? So Indian origin, and now you are coming back to India. You are pota of that Dadaji and you are coming back to India to see beauty of India. Wo Jogeshwari mein train ke humne se kaise cross karte hai. There is a beauty in this. Foreign mein allowed nahi hai sab. Alright, how people catch running train, how they leave running train, how they hang outside the train. It's an adventure for them. For if you look from the foreigner's eyes, no, for you this is the regular life. For them, this is a so much of adventure. Here, people, they don't have to go for skydiving and bungee jumping. Yaar, they are doing it every day. 10 rupees ka ticket. Bus, adventure start. Haan. Ek round bus from Churchgate to Virar. Bus, in rush hours, evening type. And Virar to Churchgate. And that too, you have to catch Virar train at evening. And you just have to say, I want to get down at Borivali. क्या मजा देते हैं उसको पता है? Enjoy, because there are lot of unspoken laws in train that we follow, which the law that not written anywhere, but there is a law. All right, fourth seat पे बैठना है. All right, then जोगेश्वरी इस side आता है तो इसी side खड़े रहना है. Opposite में से वहाँ travel करके नहीं आना है. Gate पे कौन खड़ा रहेगा, कौन खड़ा नहीं रहेगा. All right. कितना अंदर मारना है, कितना धक्का मारना है, कितना नहीं मारना है. Alright, kab rukna hai. Alright. So there are lot of laws that we people have created and we follow it. Everyone follows it. But if you come from foreign nation and if you see all those things, you feel that what is happening here? Everybody knows something that I don't know. Alright, how they communicate to each other. Alright, somebody is bringing, unknown people bringing tiffin, bringing, someone is getting in train from Andheri and the train started from Churchgate and they people are like talking to each other as if they are family members, they are sharing things, they are eating food together, they are discussing about their family lives and all. Like, how? Acha, not on one day, if you travel by any train, this is going to happen. So we have even family there. They are also our family member. They know things about us. CMA pass ho gaya nahi chal raha hai. Alright. So this is what we do and they feel so surprised about it. Alright, because this doesn't happen in any other nation. It happens in India. This is the beauty of India. We are so disconnected, at the same time we are so connected. Hello? Alright. So he should come to India. To visit. Do you think in 60 days he will understand our India? Yes. Is it possible? From Himalaya to Kanyakumari will be covered in 60 days? Nahi aaye to rukko na. Nahi wo raha nahi 60 days ke pehle nikal raha hai. Otherwise, tumhari government are resident bana degi. And whatever I am earning there will become taxable in India. So people were leaving India within 60 days. We did not feel good. He said, tum raho. Tumhare liye 182 days. Okay? Alright? So, but they should not come to India for employment. Job karne aaya to? To 60 days. Hello? Doctor hai to operation karne aaya to 60 days. Hello? This is for what? Visit. Atethi Deva Bhav. Okay? Incredible India. Atulya Bharatam. Theek hai? Tum jao, ghumo, dekho, maze lo idhar India ke. Kaam mat karne aao. Kaam karne ke liye hum log hai na pehle se idhar. Kitne log roj mare ja rahe hai? ठीक है जॉब हमारा जॉब मत लो हम पहले से हमारे हमने इनफ प्रोड्यूस करके रखे हैं ठीक है कि जॉब जैसे जॉब खुलता है हम जाते पहुंच जाते हैं ठीक है 100 वैकेंसी 1000 लोग पहुंच जाते हैं तो उसका तुम और उसमें का एक एडजस्ट करने मत आओ इधर ठीक है हां बाकी जॉब हम कर लेंगे यू जस्ट कम सी एंड गो सी एंजॉय एंड देन गो ओके तो ये एग्जांपल्स हो गए यहां पे यहां तक क्लियर है इसके आगे मुझे आपको कुछ क्वेश्चंस पढ़ाने हैं ओके So that questions we will do, but before that you need to write all these things. So can you pause?